Let's take a look at this limit together. The limit as x goes to infinity of the natural log of 2x plus 3 divided by the natural log of 5x plus 7 plus 3. Okay, so first, let's just take a look at what form we get if we go ahead and plug in infinity. So, of course, mathematically, we aren't actually plugging in infinity as we would a number, but we're just trying to figure out the form of the answer we get. So if I think about plugging in infinity, so on the top there, I'm going to get the natural log of infinity, right? 2 times infinity plus 3 is still infinitely large, so the natural log of infinity. Well, the natural log of infinity, if you remember what the natural log function looks like, it has this shape here. So the natural log of infinity is infinity. Okay, what about on the bottom? Well, I have the same sort of situation, right? The natural log of 5x plus 7, if I plug in infinity, I'm going to get the natural log of infinity, which is infinity. And then I have plus 3, but still infinity. So I have the form infinity over infinity. Now, that's an indeterminate form. That just knowing that that's the form doesn't tell me what the answer is. So one method we can actually use to approach this problem is L'Hôpital's rule. So we just learned that L'Hôpital's rule can also be used for the form infinity over infinity. Okay, so what that tells us then is that this is going to be equivalent to this limit if we take the derivative of the top and the derivative of the bottom. Okay, so if we take the derivative of the top, so the derivative of the natural log of 2x plus 3, well, it's going to be 1 over 2x plus 3, but then we have to multiply by the derivative of the inside. So it's going to be 2 over 2x plus 3. And then what about on the bottom? Well, natural log of 5x plus 7, so that's going to be 1 over 5x plus 7 times 5, and then plus 0. Okay, so what we have then is 2 over 2x plus 3. All over 5 over 5x plus 7. So the limit of that as x goes to infinity. So before we try plugging in infinity again, let's make this a little nicer. So we have a fraction divided by a fraction. We can change that into multiplication by the reciprocal, and that'll be maybe a little easier to think about. So this is equivalent to this. So I multiply by the reciprocal. Okay, so I have then the limit as x goes to infinity of 2 times the quantity 5x plus 7 over 5 times the quantity 2x plus 3. Okay, so what happens if I plug in infinity now? Well, I'm still going to get the form infinity over infinity. Right? 5x plus 7 on top, 2x plus 3 on bottom times constants, so I'm going to get the form of infinity over infinity. So now at this point, there's really kind of two ways we could approach it. We've seen problems like these back in Chapter 2 when we learned about taking the limit at infinity of rational functions. The way we approached it then is we would divide top and bottom by x to the highest power of the denominator. So in this case, if I were going to use that method, I would divide top and bottom by x. But we can also use L'Hôpital's rule again, right? I still have the form infinity over infinity, so I can still use L'Hôpital's rule. So to practice that, let's use that method instead. So L'Hôpital's rule says that, I take the derivative of the top and bottom. So the derivative of the top, I can leave the 2 out front, and the derivative of 5x plus 7 is 5. And on the bottom, I can leave the 5 out front, and the derivative of this is 2. Okay, so this looks like the limit as x goes to infinity of 1. And that's just 1, right? Because 1 is a constant. Any limit is just going to give you 1. Alright, so we use L'Hôpital's rule twice to find the limit in this case. So just remember that you can only use L'Hôpital's rule when the form is 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity.